Alright, it's your boy Walt and apparently Rick Ross dissed Drake. I don't know why when it's like y'all niggas seem cool for years. You know, Aston Martin music, you know what I mean? Y'all niggas, y'all just dropped music all the time and it was a classic. So I guess we'll just see, man. You know? Diced pineapples.
Fish tanks and marble floors, living big and bad. Niggas laugh until they hit with my official jab. Crack smoke is the exhaust from my pen and pad. Ghost writers, they get the floss, what you could have had. Record label taking a loss, are you in your bag? You a worker wanting the chart, don't make me laugh. Get the mind, tell by my watch, this a different time. Living fine, I'm getting high, it's your shit decline. Who believes he moving keys in his Louis V's? Run up on you and snatch your chain, watch you bitches bleed. Feel the pain or just the describe where you really ride. Either you niggas getting money or ready to die. B.I.G. or give a fuck if you T.I.L.E.
You got me.
You got it and you keep it tucked if you be by me. Do the job, better known as the Charles Schwab. Double R spread through the yard and I swear to God. Pop a perk for the field, go and count me a meal. Kill you niggas for free, do it all for the thrill. Niggas leaking their records when we speaking directly. If we keeping it gangster, when you see me, you check me.
Yeah. I ain't heard the diss yet, but
I see you.
Yeah. It's just big boy talk, like Ross loves to do.
Getting bullied, don't walk up on me cause the clip is fully. Niggas pussy, don't wanna push me. I'm like really Woody, like his move.
Getting bullied, don't walk up on me cause the clip is fully. Like that's just so stupid because it's like, why are you getting bullied if you ass carrying?
I see you. Yeah. Check. Getting bullied, don't walk up on me cause the clip is fully. Niggas pussy, don't wanna push me. I'm like really Woody, like his moves. But he never had a fight at school. Always ran, another nigga had to write your grooves. Flow was copying your pace, Weezy gave you the juice. Another white boy at the park, wanna hang with the crew.
That's where the diss kinda comes in there. Weezy gave you the juice, right? I mean, Weezy gave him an opportunity. I don't know if you can say gave him the juice because from the first day out, Drake has been doing his shit like in like the early 2000s. Eminem went to, I forgot the show, but he was on an interview where he was just like, he was asked, what artist do you really like right now? And he said, bruh, that Drake guy, I just don't even understand how he makes music. I like the way he crafts it, I just don't get it. If you guys ever watch that interview, you'll see like it's just, he was so confounded that I don't think you can necessarily say he got the juice from Weezy. He had the juice, he got the opportunity, you know?
Never had a fight at school, always ran, another nigga had to write your grooves, flow was copying your pace.
You never had, oh, okay, I missed that. You never had a fight at school, you always ran, other niggas had to write your grooves.
Come on now, dawg.
I'm not gonna lie to you, dude, that's really hard for you to say, Rick, because we know Drake has helped you write some stuff. You know what I mean? And we also know that your greatest hits came from your collaborations with Drake.
Right, yeah, of course.
That's really tough, bro. It's really tough for somebody like Rick Ross to say, hey, another nigga wrote your grooves, wrote your best songs, but my best songs are songs that I needed you for.
That's true.
You see what I mean? It's like, yo, if somebody else wrote his grooves, then what do you say about you? Like, you needed him to get hits. Every song that Drake and Rick Ross has done is Rick Ross's biggest song. Rick Ross doesn't have a song without Drake that's bigger than any song he has with Drake. Not one. Not one.
No shit, Sherlock.
So it's crazy for him to say that. It doesn't make sense. It just doesn't.
Niggas pussy don't wanna push me, I'm like really Woody, like his moves. But he never had a fight at school, always ran, another nigga had to write your grooves. Flow was copy and paste, Weezy gave you the juice.
Flow was copy and paste, Weezy gave you the juice? Lil Wayne doesn't rap anything like Drake.
Boy, ain't no fucking way, boy.
That's the problem with when you get into like a rap battle with somebody or you go for a diss, but the shit that you're saying just doesn't make sense. His flow is copy and paste, but he's the only one that sounds like him ever. The only person closer to him, to the way that he delivers lyricism, is Jay-Z. Him and Jay-Z have that way of like Big Boss Talk, da-da-da-da-da. But even you do Big Boss Talk, and you don't do it anything like Drake does. So that doesn't make any sense for you to say that shit.
That don't make no sense.
Flow is copying your pace. Weezy gave you the juice. Another white boy at the park wanna hang with the crew. Pulitzer Prize winner switching up like dyed denim.
He said, did he say another white boy at the park wanna hang with the crew?
Man, what the fuck is you what talking about?
So now we're going back to early 2000s when everybody was making fun of Drake for being a light-skinned Canadian. Is that what we're doing?
Why? Why? Why?
Yeah, I don't like this. I don't like this from you, Rick Ross. This is you didn't do your homework. You didn't do your homework. You didn't come ready and prepared to actually say anything real or substantial. Everything you're saying right now is really bullshit. I'm being a thou.
Get incentives for all the killings while we ride rentals. Look me right in my face. He beginning to shake. Told you niggas stay scheming. I'm predicting my fate. Got more money than you. Fuck you want me to say? 50 mils for the.
Rick, you don't have more money than Drake. What the fuck are we talking? This is what you don't understand. I am such a big fan of Rick Ross, and right now he's disappointing me on all counts.
What the fuck are you talking about, man?
What are you doing, Rick? What are you doing, dude? The majority of what you're saying is just like, it's just random shit, right? It's still you kind of like Big Boss talking, but then when you're actually throwing disses or shade at Drake, it's not disses or shade that makes any sense. It's not even true shit. You're actually just saying a bunch of lies. I don't understand.
Stop the cap.
This is very disappointing right now. This is really fucking disappointing.
Crib, where you want me to stay? How can you fuck you want me to say? 50 mils for the crib, where you want me to stay? I can shoot up the block. I got bitches to paint. Let you DM my old, but got bitches you can't. Let you get on my songs. It was good for your face. Now bitch nigga is home and no room for debate.
Let you get on my songs. It was good for you. All right. You know what? Let's just do this because at this point, I'm sick of this. I don't even remember Rick Ross really doing anything on Deuces. Money in the Grave, No New Friends is a Drake song. And, you know, Money in the Grave too, right? Both of these are Drake's. So Drake brought you on there. Diced Pineapple was Rick Ross, right? It was a Rick Ross song. But again, the best parts of that song was Drake's part. Drake's verse was far better than your verse in that song. Every time he has a song with Drake, Drake's verse is better. Gold Roses, Drake's verse was better, right? Like Made Men, Free Spirit, Lemon Pepper Freestyle, Aston Martin Music, The Hook, dude, it doesn't make sense for Rick Ross to say, oh my God, you hopped on my songs to get some type of clout. Hopping on my songs were good for your face when it's like, nigga, he helped you with every single one of your best songs. Without him on those songs, they're trash. Without Drake on ASMR music, without him on Gold Roses, without him on any of that, those songs are garbage. Nobody's playing those shits back.
Say, hold up, wait a minute. Something ain't right.
I'm not liking this from you, Rick.
Pop a perk for the feel.
I'm not liking
this. Go and count me a meal. Can you niggas for free? Do it all for the thrill. Niggas leaking their records when we speaking directly. If we keeping it gangster, when you see me, you check me.
By the way, I got a lot of respect for a lot of rappers, but I got one guy. He's my favorite person to rap with on any song. His name is Rick Ross.
Maybach
music. You ain't never wanna be a nigga anyway, nigga. That's why you had an operation to make your nose smaller than your father knows, nigga.
What the fuck happened here? What could have possibly happened between Drake and Rick Ross for Rick Ross to do this? Cause again, yo, Rick, this shit is ass.
That's true.
Right? Pretty much what you just did there was show us that Drake showed you a lot of love. He helped you a lot in your career. And I don't know what happened between you two, but now you're taking weird shots talking about his nose because he didn't want to look like his dad and da 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 da. I also don't know if that's true. Like, you got is that true, right? You went and did what these goddamn supermodels did with their nose and got your shit shot. Hey, if that's true, then I will lie. Yo, my nigga just told on you, bro. Nigga just telling.
Come on, man, what the fuck is you doing, cuz?
But still, other than that, the rest of this was trash.
I wanna be a nigga anyway, nigga.
I've been through a lot of rappers, but I got one guy.
stack me.
You ain't never wanna be a nigga anyway, nigga. That's why you had operation to make your nose smaller than your father.
There ain't no one to be your nigga anyway, nigga.
I don't follow you, nigga, cause you sent the motherfucking cease and desist to French Montana, nigga. You sent the police, you nigga, cause you sent the mother to make your nose smaller than your father nose, nigga. I don't follow you, nigga, cause you sent the motherfucking cease and desist to French Montana, nigga. You sent the police, nigga, hating on my dog project.
He said, I unfollowed you because you sent the cease and desist to French Montana. I don't know if he started something, if he was dragging Drake's name through the mud. I don't actually know, but I want to know the full story, right? Just him bringing up a cease and desist doesn't make me like, oh my God, he brought up a cease and desist on French Montana. Now I think Drake is a dickhead. Like, no, that's a part of the business, right? I would do the same thing if I thought somebody, you know, overstepped certain boundaries. So I don't know.
That wasn't the same white boy that I seen, nigga, when we were making them early records, nigga. When you were happy to be around, nigga, seeing niggas fucking stunning your life, nigga. Give Weezy some more money, nigga.
Give Weezy some more money. What? I don't understand. What? Where's that coming from?
What?
Yeah, no, I'm like, Rick Ross is just talking out his ass right now. He's really just talking out his ass right now. Drake was the first person that was on Weezy's side when the whole Birdman situation was going on, where Weezy wasn't getting paid. And Drake went out of his way to actually pay Weezy out of his own pocket some of what he believed he deserved. So for him to, he said, give Weezy more money. It's like, for what? Like, Drake has literally done everything he possibly could to pay Weezy back. Simply due to the fact that when Lil Wayne went to jail in the early 2000s, Drake was the person keeping their entire band afloat. He was the person keeping Cash Money, Young Money up there. He was the only one. Even Nicki Minaj back then wasn't, you know, back then she was helping, but he was the guy propelling them up. And then when he went from, you know, Young Money, Cash Money to OVO, that's when you saw everything fall, because like they had nobody else to propel them, right? So it doesn't make sense for what he's talking. Like, he's paid Lil Wayne back.
20, 40,000, 3 million, $18.
Countless folds, so it's just weird.
Rap a lot, some more money, nigga. White boy, yeah, biggest.
White boy? Rose, nigga.
We can do it how you want to do it, where you want to do it, anytime you want to do it. I'm ready. I'm ready, white boy. Huh? I know you got your Dockers on with no underwear, white boy. Yeah, you had that surgery, that six-pack gone. That's why you wearing that funny shit at your show. You can't hide it, nigga. White boy.
Rick Ross, this was the cringiest, most, like,
mid!
I don't know what the fuck made you think this was a good idea, Rick. Like, attacking him for, you literally went back damn near 20 years just to try and diss Drake. Yeah, white boy, what the fuck are you talking about? Niggas mixed.
Bitch, are you dumb?
Pardon me?
Are you dumb?
Right, he's not a white boy. He doesn't even look like a white boy. It doesn't even make sense for you to say that. It just seemed like he was looking for anything to say about Drake because he had nothing to say about Drake. That is the most cringiest. I can't. Rick Ross, you're disappointing, bro. You disappointed the fuck out of me with this one. This was disappointing. I was actually expecting some. Nah, bro. I can't. Y'all let me know what you think. Did you actually think he said some shit? Did you actually think he said anything of any value in this? Because let me know in the comment section, man. Let me know in the comment section. I can't. This is trash. I'm out.
It's your boy, bye. We out.
All right, y'all. Shit. I'm just going to do another one. All right, man. Yo, YouTube. It's your boy, Walt, man. And we're checking out another video. Hey, y'all. You know what it is. Wally G back again. Streaming on him. Better come through 3 to 7 on Rumble.